My colleague Sandhana Chauhan joins us on the big questions that the Delhi police must answer.
Almost 2 months ago, since this attack actually took place, a lot of big questions and very pertinent issues now are coming to light. So let's take you through some of them. First, of course, is why did the police not act if it had these videos since December the 18th? Now, let's remember, this attack took place on December the 15th, after the crime branch last evening, in response to the coordination committee releasing the initial video, released some more videos in response to that. So it remains to be seen why the Delhi police didn't actually act earlier and release these videos. After that, another big question that comes to mind is why did the police not submit this library video to court? This is crucial evidence. This is showing perhaps what the police say is the other side of the story, which shows these masked people entering the library, showing them in a huddle, allegedly blocking the doors. So it's strange that this video is actually not submitted as evidence in court, but was in the possession of the police right from December 18th. Then, of course, another big question that comes to mind is, if there were stone pelters in the library, why were they not arrested? This is another very pertinent and really glaring question that comes to mind when you're actually looking at the video, when you're seeing the police in their riot gear storming the library, and there are students over there sitting. Even if we were to actually say that they were pretending for a moment, but the students were actually sitting there reading. So if they were actually in fact stone pelters, if they were actually part of the violence that actually sparked this police action, why were they not arrested? So these are the very pertinent and big questions now that coming to mind ever since these videos have been released and this war really has broken out between the Delhi police and, of course, the Jamia Coordination Committee.
Now, this video war has attracted a lot of strong reactions that have come in from across the party line.
I'm sure Delhi police, as part of its investigation, will look into all aspects. The allegation of the police hitting innocent students and the counter allegation in the media which has come out that these were students who obviously may have perpetrated violence because they were wearing masks and the books were broadly closed and there was this attempt to show as if they were reading in the library. As Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, the Honorable Law Minister of the country, has said, the right to dissent and the right to debate does not include the right to disrupt or destabilize.
जिस दिन ये पिटा पिटाया था उस दिन भी छात्रों छात्रा ने ये शिकायत दर्ज की थी कि उनके ऊपर बेरहमी से मारपीट हुई, उनके ऊपर अत्याचार हुई और सिर्फ छात्रों ने छात्रा को भी अपमान किया गया, उनको भी बड़ा अत्याचार की सामना करने पड़ा। कभी कभी लगता है कि आज भी हमारे हिंदुस्तान की पुलिस वालों ने ब्रिटिश जमाने की विरासत को वो पालन कर रहे हैं।
Who are denigrating JNU or Jamia or the institutions of higher learning? Who are denigrating the public funded educational institutions? They are BJP leaders and the Sangh Parivar leaders. They are only denigrating all these universities. They are targeting these universities and they are attacking these universities politically, ideologically.